Hi teachers, I'm Sarah from Inkno and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit subscribe and go ahead and turn on notifications. That way you can be updated on when we release a new video about using EdTech tools in your classroom. Today we have a video all about how to use ClassPoint's quizzes as a collaboration tool in two different ways. We all know that quizzes are a great way to gauge your students' understanding on the information that you've already taught. When you do this with ClassPoint, you're able to do it instantly in a gamified way. So adding in that gamification leads to a little bit more fun in your class for both you and your students, plus it gives your students a little bit more motivation to learn. ClassPoint quizzes can be used at the end of a lesson or at the end of the week, one right after each other, or you can spread out your questions throughout your lesson during the day intermixed with the information and a quiz question. So ClassPoint quizzes can be used in a variety of different ways. They're pretty flexible, but today we're going to be focusing on using them as a collaboration tool for your students. This way, it can encourage group work, build up team building skills, and improve their communication skills. So we have two different ways on how to do this, and let's get started. The first way to use ClassPoint quizzes as a collaborative tool is to use it for a team competition. So this team competition means that the collective scores of students will determine which team has won the competition. So not just one student will win, you'll have a whole team of them. This will encourage students to be a little bit more prepared and not want to let their team down, because no one likes that. And it will also help build some team rapport in your class, because students can encourage each other and congratulate each other on a job well done. So, to set up your quiz competition for a team, you first must have all of your questions set up and turned on competition mode. So in this example, I do have the information here and then my quiz at the end of the lesson. So you'll see that I have competition mode turned on and I also have some play options set. So this way, the window will pop up right away and the question will be open when I get on that slide. The results will be minimized so students don't see what other students are submitting, and it will close after 15 seconds. So this is nice. I don't have to do much, just change the slide and the questions will go boom, boom, boom. So when that's all done, we can go into our presentation mode. And in fact, we can use the pick a name feature of ClassPoint to determine which students will be on which team. So if I just go into the pick a name button here, we have 14 students. So we'll just split them 7 and 7. So these first 7 will be on one team and these next 7 will be on another. So make sure you record that information. We can exit and then we can start our quiz. So I get on this slide, question is started automatically and students can begin submitting their responses. When the question has been completed, the window will pop up. You can see their responses, you can show the correct answer, and you can check out the leaderboard if you want to see who's in the lead so far. So we're going to run through all 10 of the questions in this quiz here. And when that's all completed, you can show the table, and then we want to export these results. So when we export these results, an Excel file will be downloaded onto your computer. So we can go ahead and get out of presentation mode and open that up here. And you will see that it's pretty easy to see which students have submitted which responses, and then you can use that to calculate the scores and see which team has won. The second way to use ClassPoint quiz questions as a collaborative tool is to put students into pairs. So this pair work will allow students to discuss which answer is the best and work together on this quiz. So this can help build a bunch of different skills for them and get them a little bit closer to a new classmate. So some of the skills they can work on are definitely their communication skills, because sometimes they might have to fight to explain why their answer is correct. And they can also build up their team building skills when they're working with somebody else. So when you're doing this pair work, students might feel a little bit of pressure with time. So when you're doing it, I would suggest to not check or uncheck the closed submission after a certain number of time. This way, students can really discuss which answers are right and wrong without that time pressure. They might also feel more comfortable if there's not a leaderboard, so you can also just not even do competition mode as well. This is a great way to get your students to work together and test their understanding at the same time. So those are the two different ways that you can use ClassPoint quizzes as a collaborative tool instead of just an individual assessment tool. There are many different ways to use ClassPoint quizzes, so if you guys have a way that we haven't mentioned before, give us a comment below and we would love to read it. Thank you guys again so much for watching. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.